actually finished with Chelsea Football Club in 2008, and then we had we played for the Philippine national team. Well, for me, during when my contract was ending, I was playing for the Philippine national team, and so I had no reason to go back to Chelsea because my contract has finished, and I decided to stay for a while, and I ended up enjoying the Philippines a lot, and enjoying being in the Philippines and being with family and friends. So I didn't see any reason to go back to England,
we'd always enjoy coming to the Philippines. We'd always look forward to the trips. The other thing we didn't look forward to was the flight, such a long journey. But so we said, why don't we move here? Just cut it short. We love it here. The people here are so friendly. We have loads of friends, family here, and as well, we thought we could be part of developing football here, and we're glad that this last year has got the recognition that is deserved, and we love it here, we enjoy it here. Just being honest, it's more enjoyable. England's more hectic, but here it's more relaxed, which is good and bad in some ways.
Obviously, as we said before, the facilities and the support in England in football is very big, and being at Chelsea, one of the biggest, richest clubs in the world, obviously in terms of the standard of players, the standard of salary, the standard of facilities is very high at Chelsea Football Club, but there are obvious differences. But I mean, we love representing our country, and the Philippines is our country, and we love representing 90 million plus people across the Philippines, and we're very, very proud every time we play for the Philippines, and that's probably our in football terms that's our most memorable experience representing the country, and knowing that you're representing so many people in the world's biggest sport, and we're very, very proud and very privileged, and we feel very lucky and very blessed to have been given that opportunity.
Before it used to be the schedule. Before it would be like we would have a tournament once in a while and we'd train right before it. But these days, thanks to Mr. Dan Palami, the schedule's more busy, which we're very thankful for. The national team is treated like a club team because there is no professional league here. So now we train basically every day, so it's good to be a footballer again. And while at Chelsea, you train every day, and before it wasn't like that with the Philippine team. But here, it's now slowly turning into that.
Obviously, I wanted to be in the Philippines, and I wanted to be in football as well. I started the Young Husband Football Academy in 2010, and at that time, there was no enthusiasm. Football wasn't very big, and there was no popularity in football. The only way that I could still be in football and still be in the Philippines was to create a job for myself. I wanted to coach the kids and pass on the knowledge that I learned from Chelsea, from my days back in England, and pass them on to the youngsters in the best way I could. So I wanted to marry my two loves, football and the Philippines, and I was able to do that through the Young Husband Football Academy. At young age, it's obviously they're very young, and all the kids, they're just as gifted or talented as anyone else, any youngster in the world. It's it all depends on the type of coaching they get and training, and that's what we want to do. We want to influence the type of training in the Philippines and bring a higher level of coaching. Right now, as a young kid, when you're there 4, 5, 6, 7 years old, they have the potential to be one of the best players in the world, but it depends on how they're coached and how they take in that coaching and their exposure to the world in terms of play and competition. But at this age, they have all the potential in the world. I mean, a lot for the Filipinos, the physique is suited to being a football player. You need to be fast, hardworking, and Filipinos are that. So the potential is there. but it's just harnessing that potential in the right way, and hopefully now with the support that football's getting now, that these youngsters can get the right coaching and the right exposure and competition abroad and around the world.
For me, it was finding a way that, because we did stuff like this when we were younger, and that's what got us into the sport, it's what kept us interested, it's what we look forward to. So we wanted to develop, because we wanted to look at developing the sport in the Philippines, you should see how you got into the sport, and we really wanted to bring that to the Philippines. We had the Steve Beaks soccer schools as a young kid, and we had the Chelsea Football Academy, and we grew up those programs. So we wanted, if we bring that here, then football will develop. So that's our mission. But also, as well, we see so much potential here, so many kids enjoying the sport. It's just a shame that, no disrespect to the development of the people in charge of the development of the sport, that it hasn't reached the potential it can do.